Welcome to the Capital News. I am your host, Alex Caritas. Today is April 3rd, 2019. Thank you so much for joining me. I hope everyone is doing well out there. A couple of stories I want to touch on today. Brief update on Brexit because there was a vote in the Parliament this evening. So I want to touch on that. And then in more depth, I want to get with President Trump and his recent calls for the Republican Party to become the party of healthcare. What a disaster this will be. We've had previous discussions on this. This was well predicted by this show in previous podcasts, to say that healthcare will be front and center. I also said it would be a huge mistake for the president and for the Republicans to take ownership of this. There's an article out there on thecapitalnews.com. Take a look at that. Leave your comments. But let's start with Brexit. So, members of Parliament have voted by a majority of one vote, to force the Prime Minister to ask for an extension to the Brexit process in a bid to avoid any no-deal scenario. Now, this will have to go to the House of Lords for it to become law, but this will see another possible extension, another delay. Why? Because people in Parliament, the majority of them, voted to remain. This is as cynical as it gets. This is disgraceful as it gets. Every day, it's something new. Even a spokesperson from the government said it was disappointed that MPs backed the bill, which came after Theresa May met with Jeremy Corbyn for Brexit talks. Because remember, this is where it all came down now. The indicative votes all got shot down. Theresa May, her deal got shot down three times. And now she wants to concede. She wants to say, okay, we will now have more open discussions with the opposition, having more discussions with Jeremy Corbyn of the Labour Party. And now you have this. Parliament, by one vote, gets the pass to see if Theresa May will now go seek a further extension, which was likely to happen anyway. But now this is just one more thing that Parliament is throwing into the mix that the Prime Minister now has to deal with. Now she has to go back again, which she was going to anyway, to the EU, basically groveling on her knees, saying, can we have an extension, please? You're supposed to leave the European Union, so you don't have to be on your knees to these people. That was the whole purpose. The fear by many of a no-deal Brexit is completely unwarranted. What do these people honestly think? That the internet will cease to exist? That email goes by the wayside? That the phones will all be shut down? That if you're a British company with a British website, people will no longer be able to get on and purchase your products or ask for your services because you're no longer a member of the European Union? How stupid are these people? I suggest they come over here and run for the presidency in 2020. They'll fit right in there with everybody on that stage. Such a shame. Such a shame. But here we are. And it continues. We'll see what the House of Lords do if this becomes law. Then she will, that her being Theresa May, will have to go seek another extension because they are saying this is a no deal to avoid any no deal scenario. It's April 3rd. They have until April 12th. What are they going to do? This is shameful. No excuse for this whatsoever. And I don't think any of these people honestly care. You have the majority of people in Parliament who wanted to remain. Again, even the Prime Minister wanted to remain. But at least in rhetoric, she wants to honor the will and the voice of the people from a vote back in 2016. This is truly beyond the pale. It's shameful. But these people don't care because they're politicians. They're politicians. They're actors. Give them an Oscar. Give them a reward. That's all they want. That's all they want. Don't deliver on the will of the people. Don't get together and construct a plan that everybody can get behind. No, no, no. Don't do that. Just play politics. Be fear-mongers and keep it going. Now, to this side of the pond, President Trump, I honestly don't know what this man is doing. If he's off his rocker, what type of advice he's getting, if he thinks he has to distract from the Bob Mueller report, because that's some of the argument out there that now he's trying to pivot and get to healthcare again. Of course, he promised that there would be a new healthcare plan in place during his first term. That ain't going to happen. It most definitely isn't going to happen now with the House being controlled by Nancy Pelosi and the Democrats. There's no way. I don't know why this even crossed the president's mind. This is almost as foolish as taking ownership of this economy, and most definitely this stock market. I don't know where he's getting his advice. I don't know what led him down this path to say that the Republican Party has to become the party of healthcare. No, it doesn't, Mr. President. In fact, if you go down this road, you increase your chances of losing. You increase your chances of losing. The Democrats, rightly or wrongly, mostly wrongly, own healthcare. They own it. They have Obamacare. They have Medicare. Medicare is bankrupting the country. Medicaid is bankrupting the country. We have that discussion on the economic podcast all the time. Sometimes it crosses over to the political geopolitical report. But that's what it is. You are not going to come up with a solution because it will be a political football. Because it's just a matter of time before the Democrats have control of the House and the Senate and the presidency, and they will want to undo it, which will leave more and more uncertainty throughout the entirety of this country. I went through some of the statistics with you guys last week, looking back at 1960 versus 2010, so 50 years worth of data. It's a shame. It's a scam. It's a con, what the federal government has done to this country in terms of the cost of health care. It increases at an annual pace of 9-10%. Yet we're told, no, everything's fine. Everything's great. Inflation's only 1-2% a year. Everything is perfectly stable. Don't worry about it. No, it isn't. But that's what they tell you. So now you have a president who comes out. The Republican Party has to be the party of healthcare. And now he had that conversation with many Republicans, leaders of the Senate. Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell came out and pretty much said, you know what, Mr. President, we're just not going to have this up for a vote prior to the 2020 election. Because it's common sense. There's no way Nancy Pelosi and the Democrats are going to pass anything. There's no way Nance and Chuck are going to allow anything to pass or take place. Nor do the Republicans have a plan. The president didn't have a plan when he was candidate Trump. He doesn't have a plan today. The Republicans don't have a plan today. And according to this podcast, and to my opinion, they shouldn't have a plan. No repeal and replace. Just repeal. Just repeal. I don't understand how it gets into anybody's mind. I can understand the lunatics. They're lunatics. Of course, these types of stupid thoughts are going to linger and fester in their heads. But with somebody who is supposed to be sane, somebody who is supposed to be objective, somebody who is supposed to have a better understanding of the Constitution. At least that's what we're told when it comes to the differences between the Republicans and the Democrats. They're conservatives. They're supposed to conserve the essence of the Constitution. Well, how does it make any sense when the Constitution is there in place to put limits and vast limits on the federal government? But no. It's okay. The government, the federal government, can now control 17% of this country's economy because that is what the costs represent when it comes to healthcare, 17% of GDP. And that's been the case for quite a while. Far and above any other developed nation. Why? Because there is so much fraud, abuse, and corruption, it's not even funny. You think Obamacare, you think President Obama was looking out for the everyday man? Go look at the record profits that have been made by the health insurance companies. Just look at a chart. Get on Yahoo Finance. Look up any major insurance company. I mean, they've gone to the moon. They've gone to Mars. I mean, straight up. Look at when it passed in 2010. Look at when it was upheld to be constitutional by the Supreme Court in 2012. And look at it ever since. It just keeps going up and up and up. And a lot of them pay dividends. So if you've owned them, you've made out like a bandit. I've owned them. We recommended that you own them in the Senate Guide to Investing because we're aware of the game. We know how these guys act, how they operate. Everybody wants to make it an emotional argument. No. This is all about money. It's all about greed. It's all about profits. If you're not aware of this by now, shame on you. If you think this is about the betterment of anything other than these people's pockets and bank accounts, you are greatly mistaken. Greatly mistaken. It's all this is. It's a scam, it's a sham, and it's a true shame. It's a true shame. Now, my advice to this president is to back off on healthcare, because one of the main things that he wants to put forth is to basically compel or mandate insurance companies, two insurance companies, that they must offer protection or they cannot turn somebody away with a pre-existing condition. Now, that's emotional. I get it. Believe me, I get it. I'm not being cold-hearted in any sense. Of course, that is what I'll be, you know, that's what I'll be accused of being, but I'm not. The government has no business telling private enterprise how to behave, what products to offer, what products not to offer in this type of situation. If a whole bunch of people out there think that insurance companies must offer everybody insurance, then start your own company. Nobody's stopping you. That's the solution. It's not politicians who don't know what they're talking about. It's up to the entrepreneur who maybe has many, many years' experience in the healthcare realm to say, you know what, I have a solution. I can do this. But there's too many governmental regulations on my back, so I'm not going to get into this business. That's the problem. There's too much government. There's too much government. Again, going back to the Constitution, we have a Constitution that places limits on the government when it comes to freedom of speech, freedom of the press, freedom of religion, all of that stuff. Yet somehow, it's perfectly okay to allow the government to manage our health care, our health insurance, and know all of this information about us, because that's where it's going if you have Medicare for All. It's going to go into governmental computer systems. That's all it's going to be. It's a government database. All of your information right there. Is that what you want? I mean, that seems like almost full control to me, not limited. So just on that standpoint alone, this should be shot down. This shouldn't even cross anybody's mind who has an understanding of the Constitution. Not for a second. Don't get into this whole thing of repeal and replace. Just repeal. Just repeal. That would be the best thing, and you allow the marketplace to solve it. Now, what would the government have to do? Well, they'd have to go in and they'd have to have that commission, I said, be put forth, have it be a presidential commission, and go through all of the regulations. I give credit to this president for cutting a lot of regulations as it is, but now you have to be a little bit more targeted, especially if you want to claim that the Republicans are going to be the party of healthcare. Well, get in there and be the party of free market capitalism. How about that one? How about the party of the U.S. Constitution? How about that one? That sounds a lot better to me than the party of healthcare, because you had no plan, evidently, Mr. President, because nothing has been put forth by the White House or any Republican of any significance. There isn't going to be one prior to the election, and there wasn't any way that that was going to get passed anyways, because you have Nancy Pelosi and the Democrats in control of the House. So now we have to wait with all of the other monstrosity that we're in here. This is my point, ladies and gentlemen. This is the political football. Why do you want these people entrusted with these decisions? It makes absolutely no sense whatsoever. This president is on a very slippery slope with me, because this makes absolutely no sense whatsoever. You have the taking the ownership of this bubble economy, the mother of all bubbles in the stock market, and a whole bunch of other markets in this economy, and globally. These are huge, huge mistakes. And now you have a whole bunch of saber rattling taking place down in Venezuela. You have the U.S. who wants to interfere with those elections. Of course, it's a major crime when the Russians and anybody else does it to us, but when we do it, it's perfectly okay. Perfectly okay. We're the righteous ones. We can do no wrong and no harm. So, okay, all right. But what does that mean? Because there are consequences to actions and decisions. So we wanted to interfere, but now guess who else gets to interfere? Now the Russians are down there, and so are the Chinese. Oh, now what's going to happen? We have three world powers, all of them with nuclear weapons. The United States, the largest economy, China the second, and Russia with, I think, the motherload of nuclear weapons. I mean, what's going on here? Is this a good thing? Does this sound like draining the swamp to you? I told you, I give the president a lot of credit, but I also criticize him on a lot of things too, because there is a lot of evidence that is starting to stack up against him, in my opinion. The only thing that is going to save him from me, from my standpoint, is there being true justice from the people who have been investigating him. And I honestly think if we're trying to stage a coup against this president. That's my opinion. That's what I believe was the case. This was dirty politics at its worst. This was an abuse of power by the Department of Justice, the FBI, people within the State Department, most definitely under Hillary Clinton, and under President Obama himself. These very well could be treasonous activities. That's where the justice has to come from if the president can bring justice to these people through the right mechanisms. I will continue to support him. If he does not, then we've all been conned. Why have we all been conned? Well, let's look at it. Drain the swamp. Well, wouldn't you think that would mean somebody like the Federal Reserve and big banks? Well, the major banks, they've made record profits since he's been president. Record profits. The military-industrial complex, Boeing, Northrop Grumman, Lockheed Martin, Raytheon, General Dynamics have made record profits since he's been president. So you have big banks, the military-industrial complex, healthcare continues to make huge money. These are the biggest lobbyists out there. Does that sound like draining of the swamp to you? Now, there might be a little bit of pullback on some of the foreign wars, but not really. I mean, he was really talking about getting out of Afghanistan, but then I guess somebody said, hey, Mr. President, you know, we might make a lot of money over there, you know. They might have some resources that we know. Okay, well, maybe we'll stay there a little bit longer. Syria, hopefully we get out of there, but he was supposed to get out of there a lot sooner, but we're still there. Somebody must have pulled him aside and said, well, you know what, look, you got to know how this works. We got to make some money off of this, don't you know that? So we're still in there. We're still in Syria. Now we're going to Venezuela. Yippee-ki-yay. Yippee-ki-yay. American empire alive and well. Those are some big strikes. Yeah, you want to talk about building a wall down there. Okay. Yes, you put two people on Supreme Court. Okay. I mean, if it's the same game, who cares who's sitting on the Supreme Court? I mean, if there's no draining of the swamp, who cares? What difference is it going to make? You have a wall, you don't have a wall down south. If you don't drain the swamp, what difference at this point does it make? Seriously. I mean, are there issues down on the border? Sure, there have been. They're not President Trump's fault. They're our fault. They're our fault for continuously electing the same idiots to Congress and to the White House. Different face, different name, but same person, really. I was hopeful, as many people are in presidential elections, specifically presidential elections, that their candidate will actually bring change. I mean, that was President Obama. Hope and change. Hope and change. We got nothing. And the man really had a great opportunity before him to truly go down as one of the best presidents ever. I did not like President Obama. I did not like candidate Obama. So, I mean, but for the sake of fairness, he walked into a mess. Into a mess that was started from the Clinton administration and carried through quite royally and mightily by President George W. Bush. So he walked into a mess, Obama did. He truly had the opportunity to start all over, have a clean slate. But he was bought and paid for. He was no hope and change candidate. He was a puppet to the nth degree. So now things are worse than ever. And then you have a man like Donald Trump. Looks like he's going to shake some things up. Looks like there might be some heads rolling. Well, so far, that ain't the case. Now, you don't just go after these people from day one and you have justice tomorrow. I am completely aware of that. Completely aware of that. Understand that entirely. This government spends $4 trillion. A trillion of it, it does not have. So it has to go borrow it. At interest. So that means we're paying for it, either in higher taxes or through inflation. Take your pick. Well, you get both. Sorry to tell you, you get both. That's what's going to happen. You can have tax cuts, but you got to cut spending. We didn't cut spending. Why? Because the president and his economic advisors know perfectly well how GDP is calculated. And one of the main components to that calculation is the difference in government spending year over year. Well, if you cut government spending, you're not going to get anywhere near your 3 or 4% GDP growth. So yeah, we'll cut taxes, but we're not going to cut spending. Terrible economics. Terrible. Terrible. And if you do the math, and you can look at it either from the past 2 years or just from last year, you're talking anywhere from $250,000 to $500,000 per job that was created in that time frame. How many of those people who got hired are making $250,000 to $500,000 a year? Maybe one, one and a half, probably none of them. I mean, this is beyond the pale. This is ridiculous. But this is where we are. This is where we are. This is not draining the swamp. The president is doing his Potomac two-step, wants to lay the blame for any type of downturn in this economy or the stock market at the feet of the Federal Reserve. I'm with him on that. I'm with him on that. But he took ownership. So you know what that means? That means that's poor leadership. No ifs, ands, or buts about it. If you want to take credit for all of the glory, you take credit for all of the losses. You don't get to point the finger. He didn't have to take the glory for all of this stuff because it's all a charade anyway. So I don't know if this is just ego, vanity, can't help himself, compulsion, I have no idea. But it's shameful because it's not helping anybody. It's not helping the people who voted for him. It's helping the swamp quite mightily. Huge record profits. Huge. Believe me when I tell you. This is very shameful. This Republican Party wants to become the party of healthcare. It will lose. Not because the Democrats are better at healthcare, but because this party is not supposed to be standing for this type of encroachment and infringement from the federal government into your personal life. Because that's what will happen. It will just be under the guise, oh, well, it's a Republican. I'm a Republican, therefore it's okay. No, it is not okay. This is why I'm not a Republican. Because they give lip service to the things I believe in, but they don't follow through. They don't follow through. Democrats, get out of here. Get out of here. I mean, these people, I honestly think, I'm starting to think that this is some sort of nasty experiment that has been placed upon us where they've actually let people out of the loony bin and said, you know what, go talk about these things that you've been saying to the wall for 50 years and let's see if the people will follow you. Well, they are. We got a whole bunch of people who are following these types of crazy policies that have no understanding of basic economics, finance, accounting, none of it, but they want to vote for all this nonsense. You better start waking up, people. I'm telling you, this is a scary time in the history of this country. This president wants to win re-election? He better start draining the swamp. He better start educating the people because he has a huge platform and he has a huge following of people who will listen to him. He has a great platform to get up and start saying what he said when he was a candidate. When he said the Federal Reserve has created bubble after bubble. When he said that quantitative easing was a huge wealth transfer that benefited people such as himself, wealthy people. Again, this program does not demonize wealth, but when it is at the expense of a whole bunch of other people, which it has been for a very long time in this country, when it comes because of excessive taxation and money printing, that's a fraud. I have a big problem with that. Huge problem. The president was tackling that issue when he was candidate Trump. If he goes back to that, he will start to garner more and more of my support. He continues down this path of taking ownership of this bubble and fake economy, this bubble and fake and disjointed stock market, and trying to make the Republican Party the party of healthcare, he will lose my vote. The Democrats won't get it, but he will not get mine. And that's a shame. Thank you so much for joining me today, ladies and gentlemen. It's been a pleasure having you as always. Please like, share, subscribe, get the word out. Pay attention to what's going on because this stuff is starting to get really serious and we're getting down to the wire. This is the Capital News. I am Alex Caritas. Godspeed.